is it about you particularly that seems to save the best form for when it gets really interesting?
I actually have no secret, to be honest. Or maybe my secret is just to stay calm, stay patient. I mean, I remember end of last season, haven't played for a couple of games, you know, through the end of the season. Was a little bit angry, frustrated, but I think somehow I managed to stay calm, you know, and focus on the important things. And at the end of the day, that's the success of the team. And that's exactly what we are doing day by day. We have a special group. This season feels even more special than previous ones.
Why is that?
I don't know. It's just, the atmosphere at the training ground, in the dressing room, on the pitch. Even though we all compete with each other, it feels like when it comes to the crucial times, we are also there for each other. We fight together. We try to go together throughout different difficult periods. And we also had a few one this season, actually. So, two more finals to go. We are looking pretty much forward to it. And I already said before, my arms are ready to lift two more titles.
Can I ask you about your position now? Do you prefer playing deeper or a bit more offensive? Because you pop up in all different sort of positions in that midfield area.
I think it's adaptation every single time. I mean, obviously, the holding position requires different things than the one more offensive. A lot of training, a lot of repetition. And then at one point you're gonna get into the game and you will find yourself in the similar situations.
I'd like to you said you're not a special player. I think you are a special player.
Thank you.
I think you're a special player. Well
done.
Thank
you very much. I appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you so much.
He doesn't say that very often, Ilkay, so that's quite something.
Thank you.
Was there a point in the season, you talked about there being ups and downs, was there a point in the season where you felt something just clicked, something just changed, and we saw a different Manchester City from that point onwards?
Maybe something happened after that Forest game away, when we were in full control throughout 90 minutes and we conceded after the 85th, I think, or the 86th. And at the end of the day, we lost 2 points there. Maybe something changed there, even though I feel like we played a really good game over there. We had amazing chances to score a second, a third one. But that shows how competitive the Premier League is. I mean, Arsenal dropped at Forest yesterday 3 points, and that made us the champions. So the Premier League is the best league in the world. And even more, to win it 3 times in a row, 5 in, for me, 7 years, it's just unbelievable.
Ilkay, last year you did it obviously without a recognised striker. Sometimes you find yourself in that role. This year with Erling Haaland, what have you enjoyed more and what's the differences between the 2 years?
Well, our game with Erling changes. We have someone in there that most of the time is able to attract a couple of centre-backs. So that most of the time gives us one extra man in our build-up, which is always what we're looking for, actually, which is crucial also to our type of football. And when we are brave, and I think a really good example are the two Real Madrid games, the one away and the one at home. We didn't play bad, I think, in the first leg, but we were not brave enough. We had one more man in the middle, especially when John and Rodri were against Modric. We had to beat that man, you know, with these two players. And if you compare the second leg, the game at home, them too, they have done an unbelievable job. And they made it for us up front so easy afterwards, once they beat Modric. And Erling gives us this quality, you know. He is able to attract at least two defenders. And that gives us a lot in our build-up.
Just one more question, because I was wondering, when Pep Guardiola decided to play with maybe Rico Lewis coming to midfield from right back or John Stones coming into midfield, did you think, this is crazy, we can't do this, we're going to leave ourselves short at the back? Or did you just think this is genius?
I remember the first couple of years we tried it actually in a similar way when we had Fabian Delph sometimes stepping into that role. Alex Zinchenko did it also from time to time. So it's nothing really new. But the fact that we haven't done it for maybe a couple of years, but then we get back to it, I think just shows that somehow you have to adapt sometimes, you know, to the opponents. Sometimes you feel like certain players in certain positions, it just clicks. We talked about that before, you know, the click. And that's exactly what happened with John, probably most of the season, but then also with Rico. We know that Rico also brings this quality into it. I enjoyed it a lot, you know, playing with him actually in there against Leeds. A couple of weeks ago. So we have the right players for these kind of situations. And I think that makes us so good.
Thank you so much for your time, Ilkay. You need to rest those arms now.
Thank you.
You might have to do some more lifting.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for joining
us.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Ilkay Gundogan, who, as we heard, is his future is in question. And Manchester City have made it clear to us that today is not a day to be asking questions about the future. It's about the here and now. Manchester City title winners for the third successive season. And for the first time, Ilkay Gundogan, the man lifting the trophy. You can tell how proud he was of that. And as Roy said to him, a special player who would certainly leave a hole in this Manchester City team were he to leave. But every time you talk about this City team, when there is the odd injury, like we've seen Kevin De Bruyne miss games, or Erling Haaland had an injury at the start of the season, you think, oh, this could be the time. And it never quite works out like that.
No, and even when you speak, I know you speak to some of the City players about the change of positions, they all seem to come across as they've got a real lot of football intelligence, because you do have to know the game, and these lads do know the game. So when you're asking experienced players, change roles or whatever it might be, the really top players adapt to it. They do take it in their stride.
Surely that can't be a coincidence, Roy.
No, of course not. Obviously, that's part
of the
whole...
That's the way they recruit,
surely,
isn't it?
That's part of the package, obviously, yeah.
I mean, you could look at Julian Alvarez as well, someone who came in for, well, the relative bargain, it seems, of £14 million. But how incredibly well he adapted to the Premier League.
Yeah, of course. Some players just take longer than others. Other times, lads hit the ground running. It does help when you come into a winning team, and then you need to help your teammates around you. So, yeah, different personalities, different challenges. But it all comes then back to the manager, when he knows when to put players in, when to take them out. If you remember Foden a few years ago, everyone was saying Foden needs to go out on loan. Pep was patient with him, and now look at him getting his rewards.
Jeff Shreves is doing the honourable job for us of dragging him away. He's had one of those evenings where he's stopped for a photograph with everybody, he's had a conversation with everybody, and why not? This doesn't come around too often, does it? Five Premier League titles.
Congratulations.
Thank you, man.
You've really enjoyed these celebrations this time, Pep. Does it feel more special every time you win this trophy?
Yes, of course. All Premier League is special. The last season was more special for the way the game was. So, but always it's so difficult to win it. Every time looks like more difficult. If you tell me, oh, next season what's going to happen, imagine to win it again. So it's difficult, but here we are.
In the end, you did it with three games to spare, but how hard did you and the team have to work for it this time?
Quite similar to Liverpool side. Arsenal make only 50 points in the first leg, so you should have sustained that rhythm. Would have almost impossible catch up. Would think, okay, we have to push them and wait, but we never have to do it, stay there, or, you know, top of the league, or quite similar. But after that, it was a difficult, tough games in Fulham and Everton, and even here West Ham, because the middle Champions League games, FA Cup semi-finals, so many games when we are to, and you never know, never how we are going to respond. But again, the team was outstanding, I would say.
You know, in my prime, you have a couple of right backs on the show, me and Gary Neville. You got the fullback going into midfield. Who would you rather pick, me or Gary Neville, to do that midfield role?
Definitely you don't have level to play there.
I have the level?
To play inside, no.
No! That aside? They can't walk a role then?
You have to run up and down.
Up and down, okay, okay. And Gary Neville?
I don't think so, neither.
It's almost though we saw something different again, Pep, with your team, the way you set up. The way we saw Rico Lewis going into midfield and then John Stones doing it. Was that something that you had always planned? Or did you see something on the training ground? Tell us a little bit about that.
No, there are one principle that we try to do, to have one more player, two more players in the middle. In the middle, that means in the middle. No, in the middle. And have an Erling, we have to adapt a little bit our process, but not anyone can play there. Rico Lewis can do it, John surprises to play there, but the main target is put one more player there in that position. This is the reason why.
So you didn't think that John Stones was able to do it, or you weren't sure about his skills to do that job for you at first?
I remember 2 seasons ago in a FA Cup, he played there in that position, in the row in the middle, and it was not convinced me, but you know, for the process and, you know, talk to him and practice. And I said, yeah, he can do it. And you have to be open-minded, and finally the music, or no.
So there's hope for me, there's hope for me yet.
No, there's no hope, there's no hope. So.
Can I ask you about Nathan Ake and his progression this season? He's been outstanding.
Have been fundamental for us. So I learned this season when you play against Saka or against Vinicius or against this type of wingers, Martinelli or Salah or Mane in the past, you need the proper defenders to win duels one against one. Otherwise, in this competition, Champions League or in that levels, they need one action to beat you. And Nathan gave us that boost that didn't have in the past. I think the biggest step this year, one in the back four, was a real proper defenders. You know, I win your duel. In our box, I win my duel. And in the past, we didn't have it. And Nathan made like Manu Akanji or of course Kai Walker, he can do it. And everyone making a step forward in that sense.
Pep, these are obviously great days, but one day when it's all over and you've got a nice glass of red wine, how do you want to be remembered as a manager? Because I think personally, I don't want to embarrass you, but I think you've changed football.
No.
I believe that.
I have been so nice, so it was having fun, so I know that the feeling. And it's true, so we have to win Europe, you know, to be considered something like be remembered. But always is unfair, you know. I don't have the feeling, just in case we are not able to win it, and 10 of there. The Premier League makes sense too. So, of course, you as a club, you get another level. That's for sure, you have to admit it. You have to win Europe, Champions League to be considered one of the best teams like Roy Keane, United was, or Liverpool in that sense. But those is unfair to say if you don't win it, Premier League five in a row don't make sense. Of course, makes sense. Of course, it's important. So, because every day, every week, it's like now, start now the Premier League, in the next 6 years, you have to win five times. So,
good luck.
It's crazy.
Well, good luck following you.
So, no, it's impossible, you know, start. So, because this club, won five in the last six, but six in the last 10 and seven in the last 12. So in 12 years, we won seven times. It's amazing. It's not with me, always with Mori, with Manuel, with Mancini. So that means this club in one decade have been stable, but everybody knows. So
two
if
we
want to be considered
ten.
One real team, we have to win the Champions League. That, I'm sorry, but we have to admit it.
Two more finals, 2 weeks, and then back on the golf course. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Enjoy. Thank you, guys. Thank you, Roy.
And of course, we wish you luck with that, Pep, as well. Congratulations on another Premier League title and two huge finals on the way. Huge because that could lead them to their first ever treble. Well, as Jamie said it, the guys have said it, simply the best Pep Guardiola. He has taken City to become the dominant force of English football, and you just don't know where this period of sky blue success is going to end. The season is not done. We have Monday night football and a crucial one as Newcastle United take on Leicester tomorrow night with Gary and Jamie in the studio. Wednesday night we'll see Man City again in action. What kind of team they will line up with against Brighton, who have today secured their first ever place in European football. Congratulations to them. It's their best ever finish as well. They just need one more point to be sure of it being Europa League rather than the Conference League. And on Thursday night, Manchester United take on Chelsea. We haven't mentioned them much today, but they were beaten here again and they cannot wait for the season to end, it feels. All the drama coming your way from the final round of the PGA Championship with Rory McIlroy at contention next on Sky Sports Main Event. Manchester United lead 1-0 in the derby against City, and as things stand, Chelsea will not be crowned champions just yet, despite winning earlier. That's next on Sky Sports. It's our thanks to Micah, to Roy and to Jamie Redknapp, and our thanks to Manchester City as well for putting on a real show here at the Etihad Stadium as they were crowned champions for the third successive season. Bye from us.
There it goes. I would suggest that's the first of many, very many.
De Bruyne!
Well, this is why they are champions. And that is a goal of champions class.
De Bruyne scores!
Nothing less than massive. The goals flow and flow.
The striking Viking gets another.
Well, they can hurt you from any angle.
And Kevin De Bruyne scores.
He's done it. The highest scorer in a Premier League season.
And he is having the time of his life.
And now the champions have it to lose.
Manchester City have